Let's get started. We have a 2011 B8 Audi A4 Quattro. Needs an axle boot. So let's replace this axle boot. The first thing we're going to do is remove the wheel. I'm going to remove this plastic guard cover thing, whatever that is, I don't know. But we're going to remove it. It's two plastic nuts. 10 millimeter heads. And, let's see, does that come off? I don't know what that does, really. Okay. All right. We're gonna take out, this is triple square. Let me find a triple square. It's a 10 triple square. Can probably get one at AutoZone. I found a Snap-on one from another mechanic. So let's go ahead and we will use the impact gun. That's me. This is our axle boot. CB boot. In there. Maybe I'll pull it to the side. Okay. So here we have what is this? 19. H19. And that's the one. Alright. I believe my big gun's gonna take this off. I believe in it. Need a little. We gotta put push. Just come out my hand. Give it a little up and down jiggle. Kind of pull. Use both hands. And it popped out. Alright.
Okay, you prickle.
Now, I need the vise. Too bad. Just enough so it stays. That's pretty steady. Let's take a look at this new one. Let's see what we get with it. We are using a KN? GKN. Oh, there's a new bolt. That's nice. I don't have to use that fucked up one. And same size. That can go in the spare bolts pile. Get two packets of grease. And two clamps. Alright. Okay. Like I said, we get the new boot. Let's compare. Looks a little larger. Feels like it's made out of the same material. I think that's good. Okay. Both clamps and the little clip. I don't think we're going to use that little clip. I think we'll use the same one. But let's get these old clamps off of here. I usually get these off. Get them in there. Twist until that picks up. This one, let's keep twisting until it's flat, kinda. Same thing with the other side. Where the boot broke, I started spewing all the grease out. I find this makes it a little easier for myself. Garbage. Like gross. Alright. So, let's get that off and clean it up a little bit. You can use a soft metal punch. What I have is a non-hardened bolt here. Usually use that. Right on these tabs, the ones that aren't, you don't want to hit this edge or damage any of that stuff. So you want to get it right. Turn on these little tabs here. Takes 10 minutes to take it off, and it's, I don't have to fuck with it. It's a lot easier to do it up.
I never take that.
I didn't have to take any, no control arms out. You take out the 6 bolts, you take out this, you push it in, and it comes right out. And then I can work with it on the vise.
But I usually leave the shaft when you take the 6 bolts out.
Let's wash this bitch out, huh? You may not have a parts washer. A couple cans of brake clean. Yeah, you don't gotta get it perfect, but I like to get all the old grease out. I like it to be nice and clean when I put it back together. Careful for that. If you push too far, the balls can come out of here. That is something we do not want to happen. Do not want to lose those balls, because then you have to buy an entire new CV joint or axle if the CV joint by itself is not available. Make sure when you're packing it, you get it between all the balls. You want to see it come out. And then make sure, again, switch to the next one. Just do that. Keep it. Pack the grease. You want to get your finger in there and pack it up behind all these balls. So you see it start to come out. Second one, cut the corner off, fill that with grease, fill the whole top with grease. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to get some grease on here. Slide that loop. You want to kind of twist it so it makes it over the little clipping. Slide it on. And just kind of go back as far as you can. And old rubber boots, not these hard plastic ones. It's easier to slip it back further. But line up the splines. As you feel them line up, give it a little start. A little depth below. I'm gonna use this. The rest of the grease to fill in the boot. Grab the old nut, thread it in, make sure the vise is tight, and then drive it in. That's all the way in. That is way past the clip, so we're good. Make sure the groove in the boot falls into the groove in the CV joint. I've cut my own screwdriver down to fit in this little square here. What I'm gonna do is get this lined up and pretty damn close. Just to fit into that groove there. And excellent. A bunch of different versions of this tool to crimp these clamps. This one seems to be by KD. That's what I got, so let me use that. Here it is. Get those lined up. Start squeezing. Start pressing the two edges, and this thing will come down and hold it in place. There's a groove where this little one sits. This will be a little more challenging. So this one will be a little more difficult. I get that second one. And that's it. Now, you don't want to put them both at the same position. You always want to offset them. So what I'm going to do is we're going to turn that upside down. We'll spin the whole axle so that clamps upside down. So now this one's on the bottom here. We're going to line that up so that's in the groove. And I'm going to start squeezing. Sure that's in the groove. Sure, there's a torque spec on that, but as tight as you can get it with your impact gun, it seems to work fine, so. Catch one. Catch a second one. Like to catch all of them before I tighten any of them. keeps you from having to backtrack and go loosen some, because the hole doesn't line up because you tightened it without all the bolts in. So sure they're all in. Does not matter very much, but when I tighten every other one first, and then so they all get tightened, kind of like a wheel. You want to be doing a star pattern, so I'll skip one, tighten the next one, skip one. And then I'll take this one. I'll skip one. Take this one. Skip one. Take this one. That is all six, but now I'm gonna go around and check everyone in a row. Make sure. Install this piece. Get back up in kind of like just sits in there. Only a plastic nut. Reinstall the wheel. Always tighten the wheel in a star pattern.